Hey there, welcome back. Today we're going to build a very basic Arduino motion-activated servo spotlight. When motion is detected, the light will come on and the servo will aim that spotlight wherever the motion was detected. There are a number of ways you can achieve something like this. It's going to be a lot of fun. I think you're going to like it. Let's get started. So this is all the components you'll need for the project today. I'll be using some male-to-male and male-to-female jumper wires, a good number of those. You also need your servo motor. This is the MG995 servo motor. It's a little beefier, a little bigger than the mini servo motor that I've been using in the past. And if you have this, it's totally fine. You can use that as well for what we're doing today. And we'll be using, I used a straw, cut up a straw, and you'll see why in just a moment. A 5mm LED. We'll be using three of these motion sensors. This is the HC-SR501 PIR motion sensor. Use three of those. I've used a number of those in the past videos. A 220 ohm resistor, and that's for my LED. And a small breadboard. You can use big, whatever. It's a breadboard. Breadboard power supply with a 9 volt wall adapter here in the barrel jack. And I'll be using the Elegoo Mega 2560 board here. This is a Arduino Mega, and of course a power supply to the USB, so I'll be having this plugged into the computer, but you could easily also power it externally too if you wanted. It's important you check out the data sheet for your servo motor. This one is a servo motor that runs on an operating voltage of 4.8 volt to 7.4 volt or 7.2 volt. I'll be using 5 volt today, and it should be fine for what we're doing. And you also want to know that what the colored wires are for. The orange is your pulse width modulation wire, or your signal wire. The red is your VCC wire, and this runs off of, like I said, 5 volt. And then your brown wire is your ground wire. Your datasheet will also tell you other important things like stall torque and operating temperatures too, if that's an issue with what you're going to do. Has a lot of good useful information, so be sure to check out the data sheet for your servo motor. Now this is the HC-SR501 PIR sensor. I've used this a number of times. This is great for animatronics, alarms, burglar alarms, whatever, and motion activation motion activated triggers. So real quick, you'll see here it's got two potentiometers. The one closest to your yellow jumper here, that one's a sensitivity, and that just means a distance. It can go up to 21 to 23 feet, something like that. So that's pretty impressive, I think, for this little thing. And then over here you've got the time delay, so how long before it can be triggered again. And then over here you'll see the jumper pack, and it's got an H and an L, high and low trigger. For the low trigger, it's on L right now. That means that the low trigger will trigger one time and the output will stay high until your time delay that you set right here is up. Now if you put it on H, a high trigger, that means it can trigger over and over and over, and that time delay will reset each time. So hopefully that is clear. Now down here you've got three pins. I always remember that the one closest to the jumper pack is your ground, the one in the middle is your data pin, and the one on the left is your VCC pin, or your 5 volt pin. I use 5 volts here, but you can use anywhere from 5 to 12. It does have voltage regulators here on the board, so that is not an issue. Just make sure you don't go over 12 volts. Now, if you flip it over here, this is the lens, and it has usually 120 degree detection radius. So if they are too close together, you might have overlap because it's 120 degrees. So it's a pretty big field of view for this motion sensor, and that's about all you need to know for that. Well, it's time to connect our wires, so I'll go ahead and connect the jumper wires to the pins on our motion sensors. And I'm going to plug in the data line, the middle pin of our motion sensor, to the Arduino pins 2, 3, and 4. Now for all three motion sensors and my servo motor, I'm just going to connect the data pin to the Arduino board and then power it off of the negative and positive rails of the breadboard so that the Arduino doesn't have to do that extra work. Now all of my motion sensors are connected to my Arduino board, pins 2, 3, and 4. Now I'm going to go ahead and attach some jumper wires to my servo motor. Remember that the brown one is negative, or ground, the red one is the VCC, and then the orange one on the side there, that is the data pin, and that is the wire that I will put in pin number 9. Now I'm going to attach my LED to the female end of my jumper wires here, and once attached, I'm going to wrap a piece of tape around them to secure it, and then after it's secured, I can stick this LED in a straw. Now I just took a straw and I cut a section off, and I used that as part of my spotlight. Now we'll go ahead and plug in our breadboard power supply to the wall adapter and then plug the computer in to the Arduino board. Here's the code. It's very simple, and I'll have this posted to the Facebook page. Look in the description below for the hashtag so that you can search that on Facebook to find it. You want to be sure to include your servo library, and we'll also declare our sensor 1, 2, and 3. Those are our motion sensors on pins 2, 3, and 4. Also declare a LED pin, pin 7. In the setup, you want to start up or activate our servo motor on pin 9. We also want to set our motion sensors as inputs and our LED as an output. So in the loop, if sensor 1 is high, or sensor 2 is high, or sensor 3 is high, the LED light comes on, that's our spotlight. And then the servo motor will move to either 0 degrees, 90 degrees, or 180 degrees, depending on whether it's sensor 1, 2, or 3 that detects the motion. Then it'll delay for 3 seconds, and then the LED pin will go low. Now to contain my project, I just used an old Adafruit shipping box, poked some holes in it for the motion sensors, poked a hole in it for the servo motor. I put some tape on the top to hold it in place. Obviously, if you wanted to keep this thing long-term or longer-term, you would use maybe wood or plastic or maybe even 3D print something to put this into. But this works for now. And I just unplugged one thing at a time and ran it through the holes and reconnected it on the other side and tucked away the wires, and that's about all I had to do for this. I've got my motion sensors attached on the top, all the wires through the box. Let's open up the box and take a look at the inside. Nothing spectacular. But that's what it looks like. Well, here's a look at the final product here. Every time I wave my hand, it's going to turn in a different direction. Thank you all for watching. I do appreciate it. Make sure you like and subscribe. If you like this kind of stuff, share it with somebody else. Check out our Facebook page, Twitter page, and I'll see you again very soon.